So very good morning guys, and welcome to the day 2 of our trip. So yesterday after, you know, the forest walk or the trek, you know, we were very tired, and after that we went to Agumbe Sunset Point. So then after that we were very exhausted, and then, you know, there was a campfire put up, had stomach full of food. I was very exhausted, so because of that, and I didn't shoot any video. So now it's day 2, and we'll be going for some sightseeing today. We're going to Kavale Durga Fort and Kundadri Hills, if I'm not wrong. I think like some 15 kilometers from here, I hope. So that's the agenda for today, so let's go.
Our plan for day 2 was to visit Kundadri Hills and Kavale Durga Fort, but had to drop Kundadri Hills and we left for Kavale Durga Fort. Kavale Durga Fort was around 40 kilometers from our homestay in Agumbe, so we took a bus and an auto to reach there. Exploring forts is something I always like to do, because every fort has a story behind it, and knowing the history is quite interesting. During every trip of mine, I search for a fort nearby and try to visit that. In this Agumbe trip, it was Kavale Durga Fort. This fort was originally built in the 9th century AD, and it includes complex defenses and arrangements for rainwater harvesting as well. The fort walls are built of granite blocks, which ranges from 30 to 40 feet in height. There are watchtowers as well in strategic places. The entire fort is around 8 kilometers in circumference, with two types of defenses. The village itself had two lines of fortification, while the fort had five lines of fortifications. The original structure had guard houses at each gateway. There are some wide entrances in this fort, which is said to have been built for elephants to pass through back then.
I actually forgot to wear my shoes. I've come in chappals. So that's, you know, getting more difficult for me to climb.
Though the original fort was built in the 9th century, it was later renovated and extended in the 14th century by Cheluva Rangappa. In the 16th century, it was Hiriya Venkatappa Nayaka, the Keladi ruler, who added 7 battlements to protect the fort and renamed the fort as Bhuvanagiri Fort. Kavale Durga was a taluk headquarters until 1882. Later, the headquarters was moved to Tirthahalli. There were around 15 temples within the fortification, but only 3 of the temples still exist, which is the Kashi Vishwanatha temple, Sri Lakshmi Narayana temple and Shikareshwara temple. At one point, the fort was called Kavale Durga after the Kavali village situated near it. The fort was captured by Hyder Ali in the 18th century and he left his soldiers called Kavalugararu to guard the fort. The current name of the Kavale Durga fort is supposedly derived from this native term. From Hyder Ali, Tipu Sultan inherited the fort. The remains of the palace have been unearthed from the ground, and it is possible to view the Darbar Hall, the swimming pools, the ammunition house, the jail, the horse and elephant stables, and even a Galige Batalo, which is basically a copper pot used to measure time. Recent excavations have also unearthed a spacious veranda, a kitchen with a 5-burner stone stove, a puja room and a bathroom with water supply system. As one explores the fort, a structure that captures everyone's interest is a cave with a small pool near it. The cave holds year-round freshwater source called the Gada Tirtha. Legend says that the mace or gada of Bhima, one of the 5 Pandavas from Mahabharata, was used to dig out this water source. Many legendary sources also mention this fort as providing shelter to the Pandavas and the sages Agastya and Valmiki at various times. Another important and amazing aspect of the fort is the presence of the water channels. Some of these gather the natural flowing mountain waters to the various lakes dotted in and around the fort. Apparently, the fort has water throughout the year, even during summer, as a result of these water channels.
So that brings us to the end of this trip. I'm going back to Bangalore in this bus, Disco Lights bus, and hope you guys enjoyed it. If you do, like, comment and share, and don't forget to subscribe to the channel. So until I come back with a new video, this is Rahul signing out of Nature Travelers. Bye bye.